Welcome to our first game of the day, everyone. All month long, we've been playing guessing games about characters, and we're gonna play another one right now. Today, we'll have to guess who the characters are based off of a really bad description of them that we will see on the screen. I have a feeling this is gonna be pretty tough, so help me by saying the answer out loud if you know who it is. Let's get started. This character, in constant conflict with her mother, uses her elongated follicles to engage in all kinds of hijinks. She travels with a companion who frequently smolders, although he doesn't generate any heat. Wow, that is a tough one. Not a very good description. And I don't even know if I can pick out who this character might be. Conflict with her mother, uses her elongated follicles to engage in all kinds of hijinks. Is this Rapunzel? Oh, it is! We got it! Perfect. Using a shortened name of the original Michael, this cartoon rodent is a distant ancestor to many of today's animated characters. Okay, so we know that the name comes from the original name Michael. It is a cartoon rodent who I am very familiar with. I'm gonna go with Mickey Mouse. Is that correct? Hey, it is. It is Mickey Mouse. Did you get that one? With the rodent, the characters that are there today. That was a good one. A member of law enforcement, this canine works with a local construction worker and other emergency services to solve municipal problems. Okay, so we have a member of law enforcement, works with other workers around the area to solve emergency problems. Let's see. I'm gonna guess Paw Patrol. Is that right? It is. Oh, it was Chase. I was so close. I couldn't remember his name. Okay, let's check out the next one. A member of this phylum Porifera genus, this aquatic character frequently can be spotted with a starfish, a crab, a squid, and a squirrel. Okay, that is a whole group of people. And I think I know who it is. I would have been a little confused, but with the help of the squirrel in there, I'm gonna go with SpongeBob SquarePants. Is this correct? Yes, we got it. We're doing really well. Though not traditionally known for eating large quantities of honey, this Ursa class animal loves it, often eating it to excess. He refers to his stomach as his tumbly and sometimes employs his friends, a teacup piglet, to retrieve it. Okay, so we've got some kind of animal who loves honey, refers to his stomach as a tumbly, and has a teacup pig friend. I'm gonna go with Winnie the Pooh. It is Winnie the Pooh. We're doing so great. I don't think we've missed one yet. Let's see if we can keep it going. A fictional Greek superheroine who has for some reason adopted the colors of the United States for her outfit. She uses a rope like a cowboy and pilots an invisible jet. Sounds pretty cool, but I can't seem to figure out who this is. Okay, has a rope, adopted the colors of the United States? And invisible jet? Do you guys know who this is? Who could it be? Wonder Woman! Oh, okay. Yeah, that was a pretty poor description. I guess I could have guessed, but anyways, let's try the next one. A former good guy gone bad. This deep-voiced menace who wears the color black and likes to wave around a giant red glow stick while trying to get young heroes to join the dark side. I have a pretty good idea of who this is, but let's just recap. We've got a deep voice, wears the color black, waves around a red glow stick. Not sure that that's the kind of glow stick you would have, but, and gets people onto the dark side. This sounds like Darth Vader. It is, it was Darth Vader. Okay, did you get that one right? Great job. This feline intergalactic protector can manipulate fire. He can often be found in the company of an armadillo-like boy and a girl with seaweed hair while doing battle with many supervillains, including a half-cyborg and his sock puppet. Okay, that is a crazy-sounding story and probably a pretty cool character. And one very familiar. Where have I heard this before? Oh, I know. It's got to be from The Adventures of the Star Keepers. Our friend Leo, is that right? Let's find out. Yes, we got it. A half-fish princess who intends to shrug off her royal life in order to become part of the human world. This princess uses forks, gadgets, and what's-its as a mockery of human life. Okay? I have a pretty good idea, but again, let's check it what we've got. Doesn't want her royal life, wants to be a part of the human world, and forks and gadgets. This sounds like the Little Mermaid Ariel. Ah, we got it. Nice job. Thanks for helping me, everyone. Those descriptions weren't exactly what I would call perfect. What do you think?